again, welcome to my kitchen. Today I'm going to show you how to make your homemade bread. It's going to be a soft bread and it's going to be cooked in a brick oven outside. The ingredients for today are: I'm going to use gold medal all-purpose flour. It's 5 pounds, we are going to say in kilograms also, 2.26. All the flour has been placed in a plastic recipient. I like it because it gives me enough space when the dough is going to rise. I'm going to use the entire package of flour. All these ingredients for today are for the full pack of flour, and you will see how much bread you can make. And you will have an idea if you want to make half, if you want quarter of this, it's up to you, okay? Today I'm good to use the entire amount. Here we have Himalaya salt. I have 2 spoons, regular spoons of Himalaya salt. It's not very salty, it's enough for this amount of flour. We have 1 spoon of white sugar. 3 spoons of oil, is regular oil. I use just canola oil. Here we have just a cup of warm water. First step is going to be, I kept a little bit of the flour in a package. And also the most important for our recipe today is the instant dry yeast. Okay, it's one of the best yeast I ever used. I would like to use the fresh one, but it's not easy to find those days. And this is, I'm using this flour from Steel Leonard's for almost 12 years. It never let me down. Okay, for this amount of flour, we are going to use 5 spoons. Okay, mix with the 1 spoon of sugar and a little bit of warm water. This is first step in our process. Yes, the water doesn't need to be boiled, it needs to be warm water. I mix it in here, 5 spoons of yeast for the full amount of flour. Then you will see how much bread I'm going to make today, and then in your home you can use half of the pack or quarter of the pack, depends how much bread you want to make. Okay, is going to rest. First step in our process is mix the 5 spoons of yeast, dry yeast, 1 spoon of white sugar, and a little bit of warm water, enough to make, give this consistency, and we let it rise 5 to 10 minutes. Okay, as you see, our yeast rised up very nicely. Then our second step . We put the yeast in the middle of the flour here. The leftover warm water is to clean a little bit the leftover of the yeast. Do not forget the salt is going to be added just on the sides, just on the flour, never in the middle on the yeast, okay? Because this one will kill the yeast, and you will have difficulties on rising the dough, okay? You see how beautiful yeast in the middle. The salt, the Himalayan salt, goes on the sides, okay? Then whatever is left over from the yeast here is going to be mixed in the middle, okay? It's enough. This quantity is enough. This is not actually the initial dough. This is going to be the second step in our rising process, okay? I don't know how many people are doing this process, but for me it's very important. I'm doing like 4 steps before my bread is ready to go in the oven, okay? Just in this mixture, this mixture is going to be like a little bit thicker like it was before, because I'm going to add from the sides, as you see, a little bit of flour, just a little bit, slightly, okay? I want it to have a consistency of heavy cream, okay? And we are going to let it rise for another 10 to 15 minutes, okay? To make a good bread, it takes a lot of time, okay? Take your time, dedicate those hours, because at the end you will be happy with the results, okay? You see? This is fabulous consistency, okay? I will leave my spatula in here. I will just take a little bit of the flour from the package. I kept like 2 full hands of flour, because you never know, you need it like when you mix all the dough together, okay? This is going to rest 10 to 15 minutes. You can keep it even for 20 minutes. Nothing wrong with that, okay? Our 20 minutes, 15 roughly 20 minutes has passed. As you see, it rests up very nice. Now we are ready to put our dough together. Then we add more warm water, and with the spatula I try to incorporate gradually all the flour. Until I will get a homogeneous dough. Always from the sides to the middle. Too much oil. I use the oil just to get rid of the material, the dough from the recipient where you do the entire process, just to keep it clean and even do not waste the dough, you know? How beautiful it is. Always from the sides to the middle. Our dough is almost done. It doesn't matter if it's thick on the bottom, because in the last minute I will add a little bit of extra flour and I will let it rise. If you count the process from the beginning until now, it's already more than 40 minutes just to make all the steps until the dough is made. Then you need to be patient, yes. Have very positive attitude and relaxing atmosphere is very important for the bread to rise nicely. You know, don't be upset, don't fight with anybody. I'm just joking. Okay, done. Now we get it ready with everything together. You will see, put a little bit of flour on the bottom. See, circular motion all the time. Stick it underneath. All together again. And here you go. Done. Now we remove the gloves. We cover with the white cloth. I like to put this because I can measure how much it rises up, and we let it rest for up to 1 hour. Okay, we keep checking every 20 minutes. Okay, as you see, we saw the sign, everything is up to here. I'm very happy with the result. Keep this aside, and now we are going to divide the dough to make sure we have equal quantities for the bread. Now it depends, I want to make a bigger one because I have some orders to honor today, and I'm going to make some of the small ones. We kept the extra flour here. Take all the dough. I still keep a little bit of oil. It's very easy to manipulate the dough and to create the shape of the bread. See how beautiful it raises up. Put it all together. Always the beautiful part, the nice and even one, supposed to be the top of the bread, okay? Now we are going to divide the dough. I just mentioned I used the entire quantity of the flour. I just kept two full hands in there, and we are going to divide the dough. It's going to be first in a half. I don't use the scale. I like to use my own judgment. It's soft and nice. And as I mentioned, it's going to be slightly bigger, and here I'm going to make slightly big one. Bring our recipient in here, and we're going to do big one, big one. Use flour all the time, it's very important. And now we start to shape the bread. Yes, we have all the chopping boards here, we have the white towels, same here. They're getting ready for the... flour all the time to modulate the same shape. Beautiful. See the bubbles? Nice. Big or small. And this is the last bit. Then let's start from the beginning. We use 2 kilograms roughly of the white flour. And we are going to end it up with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 breads. It's going to be three are going to be like a regular size, you know, for 2 people. You will have like 3-4 decent meals from this, and 2 of them are going to be slightly bigger. Nice and beautiful. Okay, I'm going to move the big one to give enough space to rise up. I'm going to put the small one here. See? See, guys, beautiful shape. You can use your imagination. I like to make them round for the brick oven because it's easy to get to cook them. And I need to make sure, but if you could cook them inside in an oven in a house, just use your imagination, any kind of tray. Okay, that's it. Then a little bit of flour, all of them. Very important to have flour. Fantastic. Very important to have flour. We cover the big one and we let it rest 40 minutes to 1 hour, okay? Look how beautiful the bread has risen. Then we're going to cut. Oven. One ready to go. Just check to see which one is ready, then this one is next. Look different, just reshape it. You can do this process like even 3-4 times, doesn't matter. The more you reshape it, the more the fluffiest the bread is. Looking good. Fantastic. Hello guys, the bread is ready, as you see. Very nice made, very very nice. It came out very nice, very happy. I like it small because we can consume it, you know, faster, and the big ones are for orders. Be adventurous, try my bread, it's really amazing. Let it cool for a bit, we cover with the white cotton towel, and that's it. Thank you.